Redeemer lives, on the last day I shall rise again. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. I shall see him myself face to face, in my own eyes shall behold my Saviour. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. Within my heart is hope I cherish, that in my flesh I shall see God. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. In life, Sammy cherished the gospel of Christ. May Christ now greet him with these words of eternal life. Come, blessed of my Father. In baptism, Sammy received the sign of the cross. May he now share in Christ's victory over sin and death. My brothers and sisters, we believe that all the ties of friendship and affection which knit us as one throughout our lives do not unravel with death. Confident that God always remembers the good we have done and forgives our sins, let us pray asking God to gather Sammy to himself. And we listen to the opening hymn.
Snow and rain, I have borne my people's pain. I have wept for love of them. They turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our entrance antiphon. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And good afternoon, everyone. And you're all very welcome to our celebration of the Eucharist as we celebrate the funeral mass of Sammy Burchill. And today we welcome to this mass his wife, Philly, his children, Regina, John, Jenny, and Christina, his son-in-law, sons-in-law, daughter-in-law, grandchildren and great-grandchildren, nieces and nephews, neighbours, and many, many friends. We welcome Father Michael Curran as well, who's come to celebrate our Eucharist. As we come before the Lord in our Eucharist, we begin, as we always do at Mass, by recognising that all of us are sinners in one way or another, and so we confess those sins before the Lord. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Sammy, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. And we listen to the readings of the Mass.
Everything, a time for every application under heaven, a time for giving birth, a time for dying, a time for planting, a time for uprooting what has been planted, a time for killing, a time for healing, a time for knocking down, a time for building, a time for tears, a time for laughter, a time for mourning, a time for dancing, a time for throwing stones, a time for gathering them up, a time for embracing, a time for refraining, a time for searching, a time for losing, a time for keeping, a time for throwing away, a time for tearing, a time for sowing, a time for keeping silence, a time for speaking, a time for loving, a time for hating, a time for war, and a time for peace. What does man gain for the efforts that he makes? I contemplate the task that God gives mankind at labour at. All that he does apt a time, but though he has permitted man to be considered time, its wholesomeness man cannot comprehend the work of God from the beginning to end. The word of Lord. The responsorial psalm, the response is, blessed be the Lord, my rock. Blessed be the Lord, my rock. He is my love, my fortress. He is my stronghold, my savior, my shield, my place of refuge. Response? The Lord, what is man that can you care for him? The mortal man that you keep for him in mind. Man who is merely breath, whose life fades like a passing shadow. Response?
A reading for the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Alive or dead, we belong to the Lord. The life and death of each of us has an influence on others. As if we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die, we die for the Lord. So that alive or dead, we belong to the Lord. This explains why Christ both died and came to life. If it was so that he might be the Lord of dead and living, we shall all have to stand before the judgment of the seat of God. As the script says, by my life, it is the Lord who speaks. Every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall praise the Lord. It is to God, therefore, that each of us must give an account of themselves. This is the word of the Lord.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am going now to prepare a place for you, and after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Some years ago, I remember watching a program where these scientists were being interviewed, and they were having a discussion about many things. And the interviewer said to them, "Well, you know, you don't believe in a divine being, a God." And they laughed. And, you know, of course, the laughter was one of course not, I don't believe in those things. That's superstition. These were scientists. These were people who believed in figures, who believed in signs all around them, who could explain how life came to be, who could explain how we came to be through evolution and all of those things. They were not going to be caught up in the superstitions of the people of the past. You know, they could explain everything. Then it occurred to me just recently when the scientists discovered something in space, a phenomenon that none of them could even explain, and they can't explain at this moment. And it strikes me that no matter how they try to say that they know everything, they really don't. For us, they would say, we are just a crowd of superstitious people who have come here to mourn the loss of a loved one, but that this is it. There is life and there is death. There is nothing beyond death. They would say we just fade away and that's the end of it. But for us as a people of faith, it's not the end. It's the end, yes, of an earthly life. For us, Sammy has passed in an earthly sense. But for us, the very essence of who Sammy was or is, that still exists, call it the soul or call it the spirit. And for us as a people of faith, we believe that that's something that we can't really explain, but we say soul, it does live on forever. And we pray that we believe as well that, you know, Jesus who gave the promise to his disciples, you know, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. That today we believe that, you know, Sammy has gone home. He's followed the way, the truth, and the life, who is Jesus. Death is a difficult experience for all of us, no matter how young or how old our loved one is. Death does create a void in our lives. No longer is that person who's looming large, you know, they're not there anymore. We have to accept that there is a space that cannot be filled by anyone else. And we have to accept that mourning the loss of a loved one is also part of this journey of life. And, you know, the first reading who talks about, you know, a time to live and a time to die and a time to give and a time to take, we have to recognize that, yes, in life, all of us will die. Sometimes we try to put a fact like that to the side, but we can't ignore the fact when someone close to us dies. But our faith is the faith that gives us confidence that we can look at the body of a loved one who no longer lives. But in some way, through the eyes of faith, we can see beyond the reality of the present moment. We can see that, for us, the part of Sammy is alive and will live forever. He placed his trust in the Lord when he lived, and that trust, we believe, is rewarded with eternal life. Death, yes, we have to face, but we face it through the eyes of faith. We don't look at death through the eyes of the agnostic or the atheist, who sees nothing, only what's literally there in front of them. Jesus made a promise to his disciples and indeed to all who follow him. If you believe in me, he said, we'll remember at the cross when one of the thieves, who had obviously done something very wrong, but you know, Jesus said to him, today you will be with me in paradise. And I'm sure that at that moment of death, words of that type or near to that type are said to each and every one of us. If you believe, today we will be with him in paradise. Today, you know, Sammy is with the Lord and with his loved one in paradise, and we pray that one day all of us will be reunited with those whom we love. Life is not ended. Life goes on. Sammy is with the Lord for eternal life. Amen. And I now invite members of Sammy's family to come forward who are making the prayers of the faithful as we pray for the repose of the soul of Sammy and indeed for all our faithful departed. I invite you all to stand, please.
Lord, as we present Sammy's soul to our heavenly care, we give thanks for the gift of his life. We thank you, Lord, for the privilege of being part of his life and family. In faith and trust, we ask you to grant Sammy the peace and rest he so richly deserves. Lord, hear us.
We pray for all our we pray for all our departed brothers and sisters, especially Sammy's brother John. May Sammy be reunited with them in God's kingdom, where there is no more pain or suffering. Lord, hear us.
For all who love Sammy and were close to him, and for whom this death is a great sadness, give comfort and strength, we pray. Lord, hear us.
We pray for Sammy's family, relatives, and friends in these difficult days. We may the Lord be their strength and their consolation. Lord, hear us.
Lord, For all of us gathered today in faith today, that we may all be reunited with our loved ones in heaven. Lord, hear us.
Lord, please hear us.
And as we pray today for the repose of the soul of Sammy, we pray for our own dearly departed relatives and friends. Lord, hear us. And we join our prayers with the prayers of all our brothers and sisters in Christ as we pray through the intercession of our Blessed Mother Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death, amen. And we offer up all our prayers this day through the same Christ, our Lord. Amen. I invite you to be seated as we listen to the offertory hymn. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. By the mystery of this water and wine, let us come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself, sharing our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Blessed receive us and please with sacrifice here for your thumbling contract. Let us pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Sammy, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour may find in him a merciful judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts, and let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we might all live forever. And so in company with the choirs of angels we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her husband, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Fintan our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Sammy, for whom you called today from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To all our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. at the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we listen to and pray the Our Nahar. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. Communion and Antiphon. Let perpetual light shine upon him with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him with your saints forever, for you are merciful.
Shall cross the barren desert,
But you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of God and live. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest. If you pass through raging waters, in the sea you shall not drown. If you walk amid the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand before the power of hell, and death is at your side, know that I am with you through it all. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest. My young love said to me, my mother won't mind, and my father won't slight you for your lack of kind. She stepped away from me, and this she did say: it will not be long, love, till our wedding day. She stepped away from me, and she moved through the fair, where hand clapping dealers, loud shouts rent the air. The sunlight about her did sparkle and play, and it will not be long, love, until our wedding day. If I were an eagle and had somewhere fine, I would lay down beside her, the sun brightly shine, and the sunlight about her would sparkle and play, and it will not be long, love,
prepared to invite one of the family members who's coming forward to say some words.
We'd like to, on behalf of Sammy, to thank everybody for coming here today. And we're just going to ask his grandchildren to bring up some gifts here to the altar as we celebrate his life. Aveen is bringing up his walking stick and Laura his cap. He never left home without them. Matthew has a picture of his horse, his favourite mare, and Ryan a bridle, representing his great love of horses, especially his Irish drafts. And finally, Caitlin's bringing up his Irish examiner. Every morning without fail, it was a tradition of his, after dropping his grandchildren to school, to head down to the village in Castle Townsend, down to Bat for the paper and a few messages. Sammy, when he brought the paper home, I think he had more news from Bats about what was happening in the parish and the score of every match and how everybody played on the day, and he got more fun out of that speech below there than he did out of his examiner. So a big thank you, Bat. And we're going to ask Deirdre now to say a few words about Gaga.
On behalf of my family, I'd like to thank you all for coming today for celebrating my grandfather's funeral. Sammy, the son of John and Nora, and brother to John, was born on the 2nd of August 1935 and spent his life in Renin. He didn't have to go far to meet the love of his life, Philomena, who hailed from just over the road in Bonishal. Together, they had four beautiful children, Regina, John, Jenny and Christine, whom he was incredibly proud of. Sammy was a larger-than-life character who enjoyed nothing more than having the crack, whether that be out hunting, supporting Castlehaven GAA, or stuck in anything to do with horses. One of Sammy's great passions in life was his love for the purebred Irish draft, and he used to travel the length and breadth of the country with his Irish draft mares. For as long as I can remember, Ballyhwee races and fair was one of the highlights of his calendar. Wednesday was fair day, and it was only a question of who would be caught to hold a mare while Sammy was entertaining friends in the bars of the Manway. Sammy was known the length and breadth of the country, whether through the showing, racing, or jumping community. As he would say himself in fairly colourful language, the old breeding beats feeding, and so his legacy lives on through his children and grandchildren. And by God, was he proud of all they'd achieved, either in the GAA or the equestrian world. And there's no doubt he'll be with us for any future successes. Although Sammy's passing was a shock and unexpected to us all, luckily he never spent a day in hospital, and that's the way he wanted it. He came to rest in the place he was born, surrounded by his wife and loving family, which was exactly the way he wanted to go. We'll miss the crack, the stories, and of course his gentle words of encouragement. He was a man like no other, and as he would say himself, good luck and thanks, Creator, I'll see you when I see you. Gaga, until we meet again along the high road, good luck and thanks, Creator, I'll see you when I'll see you. It's been an incredibly difficult few days for the family, and we'd like to take this opportunity to thank all the neighbours, family, relatives, friends, who've been incredibly outstanding to us all, whether it be food, anything we wanted, you were all there for us. And as you all know, I'm sure, he was a great man for the border, so we'd like to invite all of you to the Lep Inn to celebrate his life and raise a glass to him. Thank you.
So let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Sammy may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Sammy. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. The response to the psalm, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Let us pray. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Sammy and the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you have bestowed upon Sammy in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ, and we are with you and with our brother Sammy forever. Amen. And in peace, let us take our brother Sammy to his place of rest.
tears have all been shed now. We've said our last goodbye. The soul's been blessed, he's laid to rest. And now I feel alone. He was more than just my father, my teacher, my best friend. He'll still be heard in the tunes we shared when I play them on my own. No, I never will forget him, for he made me what I am. Though he'll be gone, memories linger on, and I miss him, my old man. As a boy, he'd take me walking by mountain, field, and stream, and he'd show me things known to kids, a secret between him and me, like the colors of a pheasant as he rises in the dawn, or how to fish and make a wish beside a fairy tree. Oh, I never will forget him, for he made me what I am. Though he may be gone, memories linger on, and I miss him, my old man. I thought he'd live forever. He seemed so big and strong, but the minutes fly and the years roll by for a father and a son. And suddenly, when it happened, there was so much left unsaid. No second chance to tell him thanks for everything he'd done. Never will forget it.